carbon and its compound. In this chapter, we will be studying about carbon, its allotropic forms, and hydrocarbons. Basically, this chapter belongs to organic chemistry. Now, let's study about unsaturated hydrocarbons. These hydrocarbons have at least one carbon-carbon double bond or triple bond. So even if there is one double bond between carbon and carbon atom, it will be called as unsaturated. If there are two, three, four, the least required is that there should be one double bond or triple bond. As soon as there is a one or two triple bond or a double bond, then that particular hydrocarbon is called as a unsaturated. Hydrocarbons with at least one carbon and carbon double bond are called as alkenes. यानी कि एक डबल बॉन्ड है कहीं भी तो वो एल्कीन कहलाया जाएगा. और मान लो कहीं पे भी किसी एक कार्बन और कार्बन के बीच में ट्रिपल बॉन्ड है तो वो एल्काइन कहलाया जाएगा. व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट एल्कीन्स, हाउ डू वी डिसाइड दैट इट इज एन एल्कीन? बिकॉज एल्कीन्स फॉलो अ जनरल फॉर्मूला एंड दैट इज CnH2n. So what is n over here, where n is the number of carbon atom. So whatever will be the carbon atom, same if it is one, so over here also we'll be using one. If it is two, we will be using one, same. So n actually denotes the number of carbon atom. So this general formula actually helps you to calculate the formula of alkenes. But if any hydrocarbon is having a triple bond between carbon and carbon atom, then it will be called as an alkyne. And what will be the general formula? CnH2n minus 2. Again, the number of n is actually representing the number of carbon atom. So whether it is a saturated hydrocarbon or it is an unsaturated hydrocarbon, how do we come to know from the name or from the formula that it is a saturated or unsaturated hydrocarbon? From the name, we can easily guess from the spelling. What is the suffix used? कि last में क्या spelling में आ रहा है? Because the starting part of the hydrocarbon जो नाम है, वो actually number of carbon आपको बता रहा है, और suffix आपको ये बता रहा है कि उसके अंदर कितने bonds हैं. Carbon और carbon के बीच में अगर single bond हुआ, तो an ही आएगा spelling में suffix के तौर पे. अगर double bond है, तो suffix क्या हो जाएगा? an. अगर ट्रिपल बॉन्ड है कार्बन और कार्बन के बीच में तो सफिक्स क्या हो जाता है? YNA. सो फॉर्मूला हमें बहुत सारी इन्फॉर्मेशन देता है, नेम हमें बहुत सारी इन्फॉर्मेशन देता है. तो ये अपने ध्यान से देखना है कि कैसे जनरल फॉर्मूलास और नाम हमें ये हेल्प आउट करने में करते हैं कि वो सैचुरेटेड है, अनसैचुरेटेड है, और अगर अनसैचुरेटेड है तो किस तरह का बॉन्ड है, सिंगल या डबल. सो लेट अस स्टडी यूजिंग फ्यू एग्जांपल्स. द नेक्स्ट होमोलोगस सीरीज इज एल्कीन. एल्कीन आर अनसैचुरेटेड हाइड्रोकार्बन्स. अनसैचुरेटेड हाइड्रोकार्बन मीन्स हाइड्रोकार्बन्स व्हिच हैव डबल और ट्रिपल बॉन्ड बिटवीन कार्बन एंड कार्बन एटम. What is the general formula they follow? The general formula is CnH2n. So in all the homologous series, it's really very important to remember the general formula, that which general formula that homologous series is following. So to be very quick, we can see that number of hydrogen are twice the number of carbon atom present in one molecule. This homologous series starts from C2. It doesn't have C1. Why it doesn't have C1? Because in these are unsaturated hydrocarbons, and in unsaturated hydrocarbon there is a double or a triple bond between carbon and carbon atom. So minimum they require two carbon atoms in a molecule. So this homologous series starts from C2. Now how to name these particular hydrocarbon? So whenever any molecule has C2, what is the spelling that it should start with? remember that particular slide so that you don't have any problem in learning the hydrocarbons. So it starts with eth. And what should be the remaining spelling? The remaining spelling should be ene. So it will be ene, like in the previous homologous series when we were doing alkanes, we were writing ene. So right from the spelling of the hydrocarbon, you can guess whether it is a saturated hydrocarbon or an unsaturated hydrocarbon. If the spelling is having ene at the end, that shows it's a saturated hydrocarbon, and if it has ene or yne, that it means it's an unsaturated hydrocarbon. So let us see how we need to learn to make the formula. C is 2 over here, so writing 2, and H 2 into 2. Why 2 into 2? Because the number of carbon is 2. So whatever is the number of carbon, so in hydrogen also you have to use the same number. So what will the formula will be getting it? C2 and H is 4. Now how to make the structure? Learn the structure. C, one more C. So two carbon atoms, we have shown it. Now you need to write like this. What does it mean? These are double bond. So these are not line. A chemistry student should know that this is actually not a line. It's representing a bond. Now, first hydrogen. Second hydrogen. Third one and the fourth one. So this molecule has total four hydrogen in it. So all the four hydrogen we have shown here. Now let's check the valency of each atom. Hydrogen, you know, all of you know that it has a valency one, so it's going to form only one bond. Let's have a look on carbon. 1, 2, 3, and 4. So this carbon is forming four bonds. Now this carbon, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So by this time you know that the bond which is between two atoms is counted for both. So this double bond will be counted for this also and this also. So this is the name, molecular formula, and the structural formula. So shall we do one more? C3. So whenever any hydrocarbon is going to have three carbon, so its spelling will be P-O-P. Prop. And the remaining spelling is decided by hydrogen as it is following the general formula of alkene. So it will have E-N-E. So we are going to call it as propene. See how many? 3. H will be 2 into 3. So the formula becomes C 3 and H 6. And now shall we make the formula, structural formula? How many carbons? 3. And there should be a double bond between carbon and carbon atom. You can show double bond over here or here, it's all up to you. So let us show it here. So now our carbon chain is ready. Now let's attach hydrogen to it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6. Till now we have attached 5 hydrogen and this is the 6th one. You may be wondering that we are not attaching any other hydrogen over here. It's not required actually. You can see that this carbon is having 1, 2, 3 and 4 bonds. This one is also in 1, 2, 3 and 4 bonds. So we cannot attach hydrogen over here. In case you are attaching over here, then you are going to make the valency of carbon 5, which is practically not possible. So look at this carbon, 1, 2, 3 and 4. So all the carbon are having 4 valencies. So this is how you need to learn to make their names, formulas and as well as their structure. Now the third homologous series is alkyne. These are also unsaturated hydrocarbons. The general formula is CnH2n-2. So you need to remember that alkynes are going to follow this general formula. This homologous series also starts from C2. So as this homologous series has a name YNE, so every molecule will have, the last part will be YNE. So we can say that we can use, in English we call it as suffix. So they'll have suffix as YNE. So in alkanes the suffix was ANE, in alkene it was ENE, and in alkynes it's YNE. So you need to remember the suffix in all the homologous series. So now C2, as it has 2 carbon, so the spelling of the compound will start from eth. And now the remaining spelling will be decided because of hydrogen. So as it is belonging to alkyne series, which is because this molecule is following this general formula, so the spelling will be YNE. So let us have a look how to make the formula. C2H2 into 2 minus 2. So carbon will be 2. Let's calculate number of hydrogen atoms. 2 into 2, 4. 4 minus 2, 2. So this gives you the general formula. It is going to help you in finding out the molecular formula of hydrocarbons. Now, shall we make the structure of this hydrocarbon? So, as it is alkyne, they are unsaturated hydrocarbons and they have triple bond between carbon and carbon atom. So, the carbon skeleton structure, and we will be attaching one hydrogen over here. Let me rewrite it. So attaching one hydrogen over here and one over here, and your structure is complete. It doesn't make any difference if you are going to attach the hydrogen over here or here, it's one and the same thing. No such rule that you are going to attach it over here only, but one hydrogen will be attached to one carbon and the other hydrogen will be attached to the second carbon atom. So now the valency of carbon is fulfilled. 1, 2, 3 and the fourth one. 1, 2, 3 and the fourth one. So name, molecular formula and the structural formula. So shall we do one more? And I hope for the remaining you will be able to do it. So the second one, as the carbon is having 3, it's having 3 carbon, so the name will start with prop. And as it is satisfying the general formula of alkyne, so the remaining will be YNE. So writing YNE is actually giving you a hint that it is a unsaturated hydrocarbon having triple bond between carbon and carbon atom. So making the molecular formula, C3H2 × 3 − 2. So C 3, and how much will be the H? H will be 2 × 3 = 6, 6 − 2 = 4. Number of hydrogen atom will be 4. So let's make the structure now. Again, making the carbon chain first and having a triple bond anywhere, wherever you feel like. Oh, if you want to make it here, you can make it here. If you want to make it here, you can make it here also. But triple bond will be only at one place. You can make it in both the places. Now you need to be very alert that this particular carbon, the valency is already satisfied, 1, 2, 3 and 4. So no need to attach any hydrogen atom over here, because children in a hurry attach hydrogen over here. So you can't change the valency of carbon. You can make it 3 or you can make it 5. Valency is 4, so you always need to be careful that during making the structure you don't increase or decrease the valency of carbon. So over here you only need to attach one hydrogen, because already this carbon has already 3 bonds with this carbon atom. So total again 5, 1, 2, 3, 4. I hope you will be able to make the remaining structures by yourself. Now let's study about alkyls. The general formula is CnH2n + 1. And along with that, it has a one bond that is ready to be combined with any of the molecule or atom. Examples: CH3 having one bond, C2H5 having one bond, C3, and so it's an entire homologous series. Now how to name it? As C is only one, so the name will start from meth, METH. As you know that the starting of the name starts because how many number of carbon atom is there, so that's going to decide. And the remaining part of the is going to be decide that which homologous series that particular molecule belongs to. So as it belongs to alkyl group, as it is following this general formula, so the suffix will be YL. And one bond that is vacant can combine with any of the molecule, or it can, means it can combine to a carbon chain, it can combine to a single atom also, so depending upon the situation. So we'll have some examples there, you will be able to understand that where these alkyl groups are actually used. So as carbon is 2, so eth belongs to alkyl group, so YL. So methyl, ethyl, F3, what should be the spelling? FOP. And then Y. So the name becomes propyl. 4. Bute. 5. Pent. 5. Pentyl. So this is the homologous series you need to remember. Now let us try to learn how to name hydrocarbons. On this slide there are 2 hydrocarbons mentioned over here. Let's name them. The first rule is that you need to count the longest carbon chain. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We are numbering the carbons. So Here we can see there are two chains. One is this one which has 5 carbon numbers and this one which has only 2 carbon. So we need to select the longest carbon chain. So we'll be selecting this. So as it has 5 carbons in it, so it will start from pent. And the remaining part of the hydrocarbon name will be decided from hydrocarbons. Is it a saturated structure? Yes, it's a saturated structure. So we need to add ANE. So we'll write pentane. So while we are writing pentane, we are counting all these 5. And this is still left. So we need to count this also. So first we need to write the parent chain. This is the parent chain and this is the branching. So what is it? CH3. So what it's going to be called? It will be called as methyl. And we need to name methyl and we need to tell the position also to which carbon number it is attached. So it is attached to 2 carbon number. So we'll be writing it 2-methyl. So whatever is attached is written before the parent chain. So 2-methyl pentane. Now let's have a look of this next structure. So the same structure can be written like this also. So it's not a separate structure. So either you write it like this or you're writing it like this, it's one and the same thing. So the name will remain the same again because 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, pentane and carbon number 2, methyl is attached. So whatever is attached to the parent carbon chain, counting of the parent carbon chain is done in such a way that attachment gets the least number. Because if you're going to count it from this side, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, then this particular carbon is going to get carbon number 4. So we try to give it a smaller number because we have the freedom of counting from both the sides. So we need to count it in such a way that whatever branching is there, that gets the lowest number. Organic chemistry is the child of medicine, and however far it may go on its way with its important achievements, it always returns to its parents.